Snake, your first order of business is to rendezvous with the Mark II. Just follow my instructions and use your Octo Camo to make sure the enemy doesn't see you along the way. Octo Camo is a newly developed camouflage technology that's capable of almost exactly mimicking the appearance of objects and surfaces. It's easy to use, too. All you have to do is press up against a wall or object, or lie flat on the ground while wearing the suit. It can be a powerful tool if you use it right. So tell me, how does it feel?
Not as itchy as I'd have thought.
That suit can mimic the color, pattern, and even the surface texture of walls and floors. Kinda like procuring your own camo on site, right?
I do just fine with the regular stuff. I'm not a chameleon.
You've got it all wrong. We're not talking about lizards. This is Octo Camo. In other words, it's based on the camouflage capabilities of the octopus. Octopus are sometimes called ninja of the sea. They fool their enemies by mimicking not just the color of their surroundings, but also the shape of the terrain. That suit takes its cue from defensive deception found in nature. Besides, you may not have known this, but there is a snake that can change its body color too. It's called the Capuas Mud Snake. It's a poisonous reptile indigenous to the Capuas River on the island of Borneo. Its coloring is normally a reddish-brown, but sometimes turns to white. So, snakes can sport disguises too.
Hey, what happened to stealth camo? You used to wear it all the time.
All that does is create an optical illusion. It's no use against Gecko with their infrared sensors. Octo Camo, on the other hand, has micro-peltier arrays that regulate the absorption and release of heat, harmonizing the wearer's body heat with any background IR radiation. Which means it can offer you at least some camouflage protection against enemy infrared sensors. With so many unmanned weapons in the field these days, I'd expect it to outperform the old stealth camo. But if you start walking or running, or making a lot of noise, you'll risk getting spotted by the enemy. And get this, the suit also reduces the weight load on your body and amplifies muscle power. The inside lining sends a weak electric current through your body that stimulates phospholipid production inside your cells, improving circulation. That should make your life gauge recover more rapidly when you're hurt. In other words, Snake, it's a bit of a crutch.
You can cut the senior citizen crap, Otacon.
Thank you.
avoid unnecessary combat whenever possible. In this war, neither side is your enemy. There's no point whatsoever in you getting into a fight. Got it?
Thank you. Snake, it's gonna be tougher to break through. It might be best to avoid that area altogether if you can.
Snake, you know how that first gun you found stopped working? Well, from what I can tell, it looks like the problem was with the ammo.
The ammo?
I'm betting it's because they were using cheap local ammunition. The ammo probably triggered abnormal combustion, which excessively raised the pressure and caused the cartridges to stick in the chamber. It's a pretty rare phenomenon. I guess you just got lucky.
More like unlucky.
Look on the bright side. It means there weren't any problems with the gun itself. I don't think it'll happen again.
that.
Nothing here.
snake, press the crawl button while running to execute a roll. Rolling can help you dodge enemy attacks and get past small gaps and obstacles.
What the enemy? Where'd he go?
Otacon, those two-legged machines, they're not like the Metal Gears I'm used to dealing with.
Right. Strictly speaking, though, they're not metal gears.
What are you talking about?
The gears you fought before were all basically designed and produced to serve as nuclear platforms. Ray was an exception to the rule, but even that was an anti-Metal Gear weapon designed to defeat the Metal Gear clones popping up all over the world. Its value was still measured in terms of the framework of nuclear strategy. It's been 25 years since the end of the Cold War. We live in a world of regional conflict and asymmetric warfare, and it's getting worse every year. The age of the war economy is upon us. The value of Metal Gear as a weapon, the very concept itself, has changed with the times. You might even say it's evolved. Nowadays, a Metal Gear needs to be more than a nuclear attack platform. It needs to be adaptable, well-suited to fight in large numbers, traverse urban settings, and work alongside infantry. The Gecko were the answer. There are different types of Gecko designed for different missions, and not all of them are equipped with nuclear capabilities, so technically, they're not Metal Gears. Of course, there are still some of the old Metal Gears around. Their primary job is to launch nuclear strikes. But these days, Gecko are the first name in bipedal war machines. They may have gotten smaller, but they're as ferocious as ever. Whatever you do, don't underestimate them.
Don't worry. I wasn't planning on it.
Up guns dropped by both the militia and the PMCs. Remember, though, PMC weapons are locked. You can't use them. If only there was some way to get rid of the locks.
Caution!
Thank you.
Understood. The state of alert has been lifted. Resume positions.
Snake, it's me.
Huh? Otacon.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Snake. Allow me to introduce Metal Gear Mark II.
Metal Gear?
That's right. Just like Rex. But this gear's not a weapon. It's a remote mobile terminal designed to provide you with operational support.
Where are you?
I'm in the Nomad. Where else? I'll be watching you through the Mark II.
Wish I was good with gadgets.
Hey, I'll be with you in spirit. Anyway, because you had to dress up as a militiaman, I had the Mark II bring you some goodies. Starting with this. Put it on your left eye.
Looks like an eye patch.
I call it the Solid Eye. It's an all-purpose goggle that displays radar images and other data in 3D. You can also switch it over to light-amplifying night vision.
The rebels are out there.
It looks like they've got the government's PMC troops beat, at least in numbers.
And this is their home turf.
Snake, I know this is a sneaking mission, but you'll need to protect yourself.
An operator.
I installed a suppressor. And here's a tranquilizer gun.
How thoughtful.
It predates the implementation of the system. By some miracle, it was never recycled. It's getting tough these days finding decent guns that aren't controlled. Follow you wherever you go, like this. I'll activate stealth so it doesn't attract any attention. If you need it, just bring up the start button menu.
Got it.
Snake, the informants who said they saw liquid here should be a little further up. Head for the rendezvous point. I've placed a mark on the radar in the upper right corner of the Solid Eye. It's a war zone out there. Stay on your toes.
Snake, it's kind of a schlep, but I've sent you data on an alternate route. Follow the mark on your radar.